Halloween is fast approaching, and for this year's candy machine, I decided to tackle these mini lollipops. And I ended up building this catapult style robot to help deliver them to the kids that come to our door. So, how does it all work? I noticed pretty early on in the design process that the lollipop stems fit loosely through Technic holes. So I ended up designing this rotating supply where they are held vertically in these lift arms. And they sit in there pretty loosely, which is essential for them to being able to be removed by the catapult arm. The supply sits on this motor so that each lollipop can be rotated into launch position. And it just cycles through each one in order, and the program essentially just keeps going forever. So I will have to constantly replace the lollipops as they are launched. The catapult arm has two Technic axles on the end, which slot under either side of the lollipop to pull it out of the supply. The arm is spring-loaded using these two rubber bands. To prime the catapult arm, this motor is used to drive this lever, which pushes the arm down into the launch position. The arm is then held in place by these constraints connected to the front of the supply, which can slide in and out of the model via this motor at the base. Once constrained, the priming lever can be retracted so that the catapult arm can launch freely when it is released. So, as the supply is pulled in, two things happen. First, a lollipop is pulled onto the end of the catapult arm. And second, the arm clears the constraints so the lollipop is launched. The arm is then pushed back down by the priming lever. And the supply is pushed back out to constrain the arm. I also mounted the ultrasonic sensor at the front of the model so that the kids can trigger a launch by placing their hand in front of it or their candy bucket. So the entire launch sequence goes something like this. The catapult actually launches the lollipops quite a bit further out than the sensor, so we'll see how it goes. If I remove one of the rubber bands, it will actually launch the lollipops right in front of the sensor, which is more practical, but not nearly as much fun. So I might just leave it as is for Halloween night. I have created building instructions for this model, which are freely available along with the program over at jkbrickworks.com. It is a kit model, so if you have the Mindstorms Robot Inventor Kit, you will have all the pieces you need to build it. I had a lot of fun with this one, and I want to thank everybody who joined me on the live stream as I tested it out. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you in the next one.